of their accomplishment. I didn't describe him talking about their business. Setting it up without any external capital was the epitome of success from his financial lens. And finally, Shekhar, his abhiman and pride. A doting father, he was spending every ounce of his energies in encouraging Shekhar down the path of service. His commitment to Shekhar was, "Main hoon na." Papa wasn't deterred by a rapidly degenerating Parkinson's, several heart surgeries, and he kept his word beautifully till the very end. Shekhar being nominated Rotary International President, I guess, was apt reward for Papa's support. His health failed him many a time, and yet he stood tall, rising each time with greater zest and desire to live it up. His favorite quip to anyone asking him how he was, despite him being absolutely down and out, was a prompt, "Better than you." Papa was determined to get busy living. In summary, I will quote what Marilyn Monroe once said: "We're all of us stars, and we
Danny join kiya."
This is KK, and Papa, as I called him, more than a friend, than a father-in-law. And what do I say for you? We shared a very special bond. I'm greatly indebted for all that I have learned from you, lessons of life, work, investing, family, and so much more. Always positive, happy, and a very outgoing human being. He treated both Chirag and me like his own sons. Today, I share the feelings and thoughts that have been expressed by extended family and friends over the last few days. You will always be in our thoughts and prayers.
खाली लीप तो मेरा ऑप्शन ही नहीं है। तेरा क्या दिखा रहा है? तेरा ये बोल। प्रकाश मुंद्रा है ज्वाइन, अभिषेक जितानी है ज्वाइन, Gunashree Gogoi has joined. हम तो कर लिया, लेकिन हम तो अब ठीक है, चल कर प्रमोट करके तेरे को मैं कोहोस्ट बना देता हूँ। ज्वाइन कर, ठीक है।
Subhajita.
Yes, Danny.
Yeah, we have a few like Jioni P5L. Can you identify?
No, I can't identify those people. How many times I said that boss?
There is someone called DN19X. There also we cannot identify.
No. I do not even RISM 3240. Who is that?
Yeah, that also I don't know. What is the full form of RISM?
Rotary India Sanitary Mission.
Oh, I don't know. Because Chandida I have found and already.
Chandida was in which name?
Chandi Mandal. He's already there in the panel list.
So he was with name. Okay, Shyamal Kumar Das you have brought in. Okay.
Yes. Oh, we got Sivani Tibrewal. Sivani is as DN19 something. I will have to rename her.
Sivani, please join with your own name.
I am renaming. Okay. Done. There is a Galaxy on 5 now. RISM is Bharatmani Pradhan from Kalimpong.
Okay.
Does he go to panelist?
Ek minute dekh lo, pehle you put the president elects. Okay. If there is a space, definitely you can bring me.
Because if you put all the president elects, then
that's why I'm saying na, because you have a limitation. Who is Galaxy A20?
Whoa. Good evening, Governor.
Good evening.
Here is Chandi.
Subhajita, please keep an eye for your president-elects because I don't know everybody's name. I'm trying to find out. There is a Galaxy A20 and a Galaxy J4, Jioni PSL5. Galaxy ON5 is SN Shanghai. You are muted, Subhajita. You are muted.
SN Shanghai, president-elect Kulti.
Okay. I'm renaming and promoting here.
Yeah.
That is Galaxy on 5. IB Goyal is here.
IB, okay, yeah, 86.
Yeah, Paneshwar is also here. I am saying his name.
Paneshwar joined, I have seen.
Hmm. Tapas Kumar Datta, Durgapur Central. He is the president?
President-elect.
Durgapur Central has got a very good grant.
They also one grant got approved.
Yeah. Durgapur Central grant only, no?
That is a first grant probably in our district. I do not know. Maybe it's a three clubs partnership grant.
Okay, and Arvind Khandelwal is president-elect?
President-elect, Bardhaman.
Bardhaman. All president-elects need to be promoted, right?
Yeah, president-elect and AG put them into the promote.
Debojit is Debojit Goswami?
I guess so.
Let me promote spotlight and check.
I think that is Debojit Goswami only. Your phone and laptop, both devices are on with sound.
Participants. Gautam Kundu, RC Mango City, Malda. President-elect?
No. President-elect is Abhijit.
SK Lato?
Lato Joy. President-elect Joy.
Okay. So that I'm...
Hello, DG. Hello.
Debuda, tell me.
Can you hear me?
Yes, Debuda, I can hear you.
I say good evening to all.
Good evening, sir. Danny, who is Galaxy A50? Any idea? Danny, Galaxy 50, any idea? Galaxy A50.
Hello. Galaxy M30 is saying from Shillong Heritage. Could you tell me who is from Shillong Heritage? M30.
Is it Dr. Minal Bhattakur?
Might be. Let me check out Galaxy M30.
Pakka, it's Dr. Minal.
There are so many Galaxy. I'm promoting spotlighting and checking. Mm-hmm. It will take a long time doing this.
So till the time we have, we will do that. Keep an eye on Ramesh Agarwal also. Huh? I'm also keeping an eye.
Hello, this is Minal.
Yeah, Minal da, apuni naam tu khodai Galaxy koriya hai.
Minal da, this is 10th occasion. So we are telling you, please log in through your name. Don't give the host so much of pain of identifying yourself. Please, Dada. From next day, just put your name over there. Friends, I just got a call from National Chair Ramesh Agarwal. He will be joining here maybe in next 5 minutes because he is in a different meeting and some question answer is going on. That's what he said me. So he will be joining in next 3 to 5 minutes, he said.
That is good. We get time to Dalmia, Rajat Dalmia from Kalimpong. He is here. What is it? There is a Redmi again. Choijit Biswas is, I'm promoting.
He's a district committee member.
Shivani is there. Shyamal Kumar Das, I already promoted. Gautam Paul.
Chandan Rai also, check out.
Shivani hasn't been promoted?
Yeah, I am doing that right now. Yeah, now he's been promoted.
And Shishandu, is he there in the committee or something? Shishandu?
No, district committee. Chandan Roy is there. Just check.
Chandan Roy. Chandan Mukherjee is here, not me.
Chandan Roy should be joining them. Shivani, hi. Your audio is not coming up. No audio.
Yeah, hi.
Yeah, hi. Now it's fine.
I hope my name is reflecting now.
Yeah,
I corrected it.
Thanks to Danny. You should give a thank to Danny. Danny has done that.
No, I tried my best, but I could not.
No problem.
You convince people are not good enough.
Oh, you Don Bosco. Okay. let's have a good competition now.
Don't fight with
people now, huh? Ajay, Subhaisa. Please call out to your AGs if they are there to at least raise their hands. AGs and district committee members.
Okay, I'm telling
you. Alingbang is here. Alingbang is here. I can see.
Arijit Dando has come here and I have moved in.
I'm moving Kamikshar. Galaxy J7 Max. Who is that? Galaxy J7 Max. Shivani, please mute yourself.
Okay.
He's raising his hand. Galaxy J7 Max.
A lot of Galaxy are.
Yeah. Can you identify yourself, Galaxy J7 Max? Max, I have unmuted.
I am Rajesh Somani, Ganto.
Chairman Max Rajesh Somani.
Okay.
President elect RC Gangtok.
Can you hear me? Janine,
yes, can I can. Yes, I can.
Yes, Ashimda.
Good evening.
Good evening, Dada.
Naresh Agarwal is here. He is your district committee.
Naresh is a zonal trainer for zone 6.
Okay, so you need it promoted? Because I think presidents I have to promote first, right?
President and district committee member first, then you can go for AG and trainer.
Please check your flip. All the president elects, can you raise your hand? All the president elects, please raise your hand. Whoever is there in the attendees, president elect. Gautam Ghosh is president elect?
Yes, AeroCity Durgapur.
Gautam Ghosh, I'm going one by one.
No,
Tapas Kumar Datta?
Durgapur Central, President Elect.
Promote. Gopal Kayan? Bikash RC Darjeeling?
President Elect.
Yeah. Please mute yourself. All the panelists, please mute yourself. Okay, I've muted all. Dhiraj, Greenland, right? Dhiraj.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then Vivek Saraf.
Yes, Siliguri Green.
Shubhankar.
Tagoland.
Shubhankar.
Tagoland. President elect.
Okay. And Naresh, and then.
Because RC Darjeeling, I could see you still.
Who?
Because RC Darjeeling is the president elect.
Vikash Agarwal, RC Dumduma, right?
Yes.
Yes. No, Vikash, I have already promoted. And Vikram Didwania?
Yes, Guwahati West.
Guwahati?
West.
President elect?
Yep.
Okay.
Vikash RC.
President elect?
Vikash.
Already done.
I can see here, yeah.
No, I'm not seeing. I've already done.
He just moved.
Chiranjit Ghosh, AG, yeah, you have moved it. So AG, okay, Ashimda is already there. Partho, let me check if any of the Partho are there. Partho, none of them are there. Anurag is here, huh? Anurag Bayanwala. Mm-hmm. Sandeep Ghosal is here, I'm promoting. IB Goyal, I have already done. Abhishek Jitani is already done. Amit Mor done. Elang Bang done. Chiranjit done. Bajoria and Vijay Sharma is left out.
Okay, thank you.
Vijay Lakshmi. Any president elects left out, please raise your hand. President elects, raise your hand on the chat. On the participants, good. Uttam Kuthari.
Yeah, Uttam Kothari, Guwahati Metro, President elect.
Manoj Goyal.
Tinsukia.
President elect, please raise your hand. I've only got two.
Raju Moni, Duliajan. Aurob Kumar Das, Durgapur Elite.
There is a Galaxy S10 Plus. I cannot identify Galaxy S10 Plus. Please write your name in the chat. Siddharth Arup Kumar Das?
Durgapur Elite.
Durgapur Elite, okay. Siddharth Shankar? Okay.
Pravin? Siliguri Midtown.
Galaxy S10, Galaxy A50, those are Do please write your name.
Do not know.
Please write your name in the chat.
Danny, you can also check in the panelist list. I can see one dash dash dash. Who is that? I do not know.
Yeah, that dash 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 is also there. Yes.
Can you just spotlight him?
Galaxy A20 is G Sabkota from Gangtok South. Gita, I think it will be Gita Sabkota from Gangtok.
Yeah, yeah. President elect Gangtok South.
Yeah, Ramesh Agarwal is also there. Please.
Sure.
I'm promoting Ramesh Agarwal. Gita Sabkota is Galaxy A20. This Ramesh is... Agarwal already joined, huh?
Yeah, you promoted him, huh?
Yes, yes. Galaxy, there are two Galaxy A20s. Now, which one is Gita Sabkota? That is the problem. There are two Galaxy A20.
Toss.
Please log out, put in or rename yourself and then log in again. Galaxy A50, I cannot identify. Galaxy S10 Plus, I cannot identify.
I request all.
There is a dash, yeah.
I request all district committee members for RISM to kindly keep your video on. So we are at 7:40. So if Ramesh ji and past governor Arijit Endo, if you allow me, can we start the proceedings for today evening, because we have around 142 people joined.
Ramesh Agarwal has joined, no? I think, yeah, he is. I have to unmute him. Just wait. He is unmuted. Yes. 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 Ramesh.
Arijit Endo.
Yes, Ramesh ji. Yeah.
So, Ramesh ji, if you allow and if Arijit ji allow me, then we can start our proceedings. We are already 10-12 minutes delayed.
Yeah, please go ahead. Please go ahead.
Sure. Yeah. Sure. Arijit da, I think he is muted from his own side because I'm not able to unmute him.
Fine. Then he will manage, I'm sure.
Do we have Ankit here? Ankit, any of your district secretaries here?
Ankit and Sunil should be there.
Because I would require their assistance in finding out who are the president-elects.
No, once they come in, no problem. We can take it up. Arvind Khandelwal, I can see still he is in the attendee list. Bring him.
Okay.
Manish also, bring him. Banushree Gagar, all are president-elect. Okay, let me start, huh? Well, friends, good evening. Good evening to everyone and National Chair RISM, Past Governor Ramesh Ji, General Coordinator for 3240, Past Governor Arijit Ji. Special welcome to both of you to 3240, and both have a very close connection with 3240. One is the son of soil, and the other is also son of soil and the son-in-law of soil. So Ramesh Ji has connected to 3240. Very prominently. Basically, he is from Sikkim and he is a son-in-law from my hometown, Siliguri. Welcome, Ramesh ji and Arjun.
Thank you.
Friends, this has been a pleasure for me to welcome you all to this very, very pertinent and relevant focus area of Rotary India that we are discussing today. All of you know that Rotary India has come up with 8 focus areas, and this Rotary India Sanitary Mission is one of the prime of that focus area. And we have the subject matter expert, I call him SME, Ramesh Ji, and our Arijit Ji, both of have given their consent to spend some time with us. And we have a detailed discussion on the RISM today. They would be providing their presentations, their thought, at the top level, and then the top down, how they are looking for 3240 to implement all those things. And I'm sure this is a rare opportunity for us, after their presentation or deliberations, you would have an opportunity to put up your questions through chat, and moderator Danny or me will pick up and we'll get the question answered by either Ramesh ji or by Arijit ji. So without further wasting any time, before I proceed and hand over the proceedings to the National Committee Chairs and the National Journal Coordinator, I would request my district team for RISM to be ready with their video on, and I would request moderator Danny to kindly spotlight them so that I can introduce them to this house where the almost 100% president elects are present. And apart from that, we can see a few Rotarians, active Rotarians across the district from Aizawl to Asansol, they are present here. So I would start with this. Any the order should be the same way I have just shared with you.
Could you not cancel the spotlight in your video? Because I'm unable to do it right now.
Is my video is spotlighted?
Yeah, I don't know because it is not getting. Okay, no. I'm getting it now. Yes, now okay, I can get it now.
Start with chair, right? So friends, yeah. let me present before you past president Chandi Charan Mandal from Bardhaman Heritage, Zone 3. Chandi is a person, we call him earlier the Winds Warrior, and now with this new shape and the Rotary Mission for Sanitation, Chandi would be leading the district team as the chair for the committee. So welcome Chandi Charan Mandal. Good evening, Chandi. We have our five co-chairs who are marking the five important verticals of RISM. And as per their need, they would be taking up the members whenever it is required, and they will pick up the members from their convenient zones or areas wherever. I have given that flexibility to the committee to go ahead and choose that. However, this five vertical co-chair, which I have picked up, friends, I can tell you, they all have some basic experience, knowledge, or maybe they have worked with the subject line, and then only they are being volunteered themselves to work in RISM. Let me start with the first co-chair for ODF plus village. Let me present before you past president Chandan Roy from Rotary Club of Bardhaman South.
He's not there.
Chandan is not there?
No, Chandan is not there. Chandan and Joyjit are not here.
But I saw both. Anyway, we'll get it later on. Friends, yeah. We have a second co-chair who would be handling the functional household tap connection, which we know as a government program as Jal Jeevan. And the person who has given his entire life working in government department for this purpose only, we have Rotarian Gautam Pal from RC Silchar. Danny, is Gautam is there?
No, he is not here.
Okay, Gautam would be joining. We have Washington School co-chair, past president, dynamic, very dynamic, the only lady member in this team, Shivani Kudrual from RC Greater Tejpur. Shivani is here. Hi, Shivani. All the best and looking forward to work with you in 2021. Friends, we have another co-chair for community and public toilets constructions, and we have past president Jaijit Biswas from RC Greater Silchar. Danny, I'm sure Jaijit hasn't joined yet, right?
No, he hasn't. So
we will get Jaijit, Gautam and Chandan later on introduced. So with this very dynamic five co-chair and chairs Chundi, this committee will be working for 2021 and basis on their performance and with my successor, governor nominee, Dr. Shyam, they will be deciding to continue with this. But 2021, we are looking for with this dynamic team across the district working for RISM. With these words, I would request zonal chair, past governor Arijit Endo, to kindly take over and get Ramesh ji into his deliberations and his discussions. Past governor Arijit ji, over to you. Thank you.
Sunil Saraf has joined.
Okay. We also welcome our zonal coordinator for water, past governor Sunil Saraf, who also happens to be a past governor from district 3240. And why we are following this, because I have got a tip from Arijit ji and Ramesh ji that water emission and sanitary emission is working hand in hand, side by side. So when the RISM program is happening, we are having a zonal water chair and the district chair, Parameshwar Chaudhary is also there. So they are here to as an invitee observer. When we'll be having a water seminar, we'll be having Chandi and Arjita as a invitee seminar there. So welcome past governor Sunil Sarap and district chair for water, past president Paramesh Dev Chaudhary. Over to you, Arjita.
Danny, can you turn my picture? Because it is coming sideways. I don't know why.
That is your, I think your mobile or, I cannot turn it. It is either your mobile or your.
But Arjita, your presentation is.
No, presentation is okay, fine, no issue. But is this picture is getting turned? I don't know. I'll have to make it in different way. I can do that.
No, you have to rotate your mobile in case you are using my mobile.
No, it is not mobile. It is a Surface iPad.
Yeah, so you have to move that one. You have to move that one.
Is 90 okay? degree. Turn it.
Is it okay?
Flip
now?
It. Flip it other side.
Little more. One more. No,
but this presentation is on that screen.
Yeah, that is my presentation. Yes. So I'm going to cover a few slides and then it will be good if your presentation is there.
Okay. In my own district, my Rotarian, fellow Rotarians, they know me very well. So my picture is not necessarily to be seen in the screen. My dear fellow Rotarians, now as you all know that when you talk about the winds in India, automatically two names come. One is past RI director Sushil Gupta and the another prominent warrior of winds, PDG Ramesh Agarwal. He is with us today and he will be leading us from the front as chairman of this Rotary India Sanitation Mission. So we are lucky to have him in this Zoom meeting. Whatever our district governor-elect Subhashish has arranged for all of us to understand what this Rotary India Sanitation Mission is for us to work in the next 5 years. So with these few words, I welcome very eminent and prominent winds warrior PDG Ramesh Agarwal from Delhi to give his presentation before the gathering of these Rotarians of District 3240. Ramesh-ji.
Thank you so much. Can you see my screen, please? Can you see the presentation
there?
Yes. Okay, that's
great. We can. Yes, we can.
So first and foremost, I would like to thank your dynamic incoming governor, Subhashish, for convening this level one and level two meeting of sanitation and hygiene management. And I also welcome your past district governor, Sunil Sarafji. I have had the opportunity of working closely with him and attend a couple of his events organized in Siliguri. I was there. And then, of course, the zonal coordinator, past Governor Arijit Endo, with whom I have worked very, very closely for Washington Schools Target Challenge Initiative. He also happens to be a member of Washington Schools Target Challenge Recognition Committee. And your true Wash warrior, Chandi Mondal. I, had an opportunity of participating in a couple of Washin School seminar in his native place. And so many Rotarians from all across Northeast, including Gangtok, Kalimpong, Siliguri, Shillong, Guwahati, and the West Bengal side. And it is, I always consider 3240 as my second home. Thank you, friends, because the kind of association, the roots that I have, in northeastern part of the country. So, friends, let me come to the topic. Rotary India Sanitation Mission is a new mission which has been launched along with 7 other missions in the month of January 2020 under the guidance and leadership of our incoming Rotary World Leader, Rotary International President, Shekhar Mehta. So first the first thing that comes to our mind that why RISM? Why this mission has been launched. What is the need? So I would just like to tell you, give you some of the reasons and take you through some of the statistics. And after that, you will be convinced that yes, there is a need, and there is a need for Rotary to engage in WASH and achieve our shared objectives. The first, friends, we all know that WASH is one of the 6 areas of focus, Rotary 6 areas of focus. The other area, 5 areas are basic education and literacy, disease prevention and treatment, maternal and child health, community economic development, peace building, and conflict prevention and resolution. But all these 5 areas of focus are directly dependent on what we achieve through water sanitation hygiene. And WASH becomes precursor, because until unless there is a universal access of water and sanitation, nothing can be achieved. Whether you talk about WASH in schools, whether you talk about disease prevention treatment, maternal child health, or community economic development and building peace. So that is why one of the reasons for launch mission as a separate mission, not along with water, is it, there is quite a lot that needs to be done and needs to be addressed. The other thing, the other reason, well, it is expected that every Rotary club in anywhere, in any part of the world, is supposed to align its programs, its projects, its initiatives along with the national initiative of that country or national mission. So in India, we all know, friends, that the 2 missions have been launched by Government of India under the leadership of Narendra Modi. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, which was launched in, phase one was launched in 2014. And from the ramparts of the Red Fort, he made a historic announcement on 15th August 2014 that he wants to ensure that there is 100% sanitation coverage across India, that the India will become open defecation free by 2nd October 2019, when India is going to celebrate 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. So that was the resolve of the Prime Minister of India, following his footsteps. Lot of tremendous amount of work in the field of sanitation hygiene happened, and the deadline was 2nd October 2019. But before that, on 30th September 2019, over 253 lakhs, 2,53,000 gram panchayats in over 6 lakhs villages in 706 revenue districts, in 36 union states and union territories, self-declared themselves as open defecation free. Following their footsteps, my dear friends, over 4,000 cities across India, excluding the state of West Bengal, self-declared themselves as open defecation free. And India, as per the government records, became open defecation free. Of course, there are gaps. We fully understand those gaps are there. And you will be amazed to see the economic, the benefits, the health benefits that this Swachh Bharat Abhiyan first phase one has able to bring. And let me share with you some of the statistics, the kind of benefits we have been able to achieve. It prevented over 3 lakhs deaths every year. Reduction in diarrhea cases to the extent of 200 million cases annually. The third benefit, the benefit of 50,000 rupees per household, because with the reduction in diarrhea morbidity, the people don't have to go to doctors, pay fees there, they don't have to buy medicine, no hospitalization required. And these are the figures given by WHO and UNICEF. These are not the figures self-created by Government of India or Ramesh Agarwal or Rotary India Sanitation Mission. So these are, and not only that, 15% reduction in stunting, 37% reduction in wasting cases, 32% reduction in number of mothers with low BMI. Doctors would understand BMI, what does it mean? So this is tremendous. The Government of India wants to sustain these gains which have been made over the last 5 years, and they want that the health and the hygiene benefits to be continued. So they have launched Swachh Bharat Mission 2, under which there is an open defecation, there is an ODF plus strategy which has been launched. So the Rotary is going to engage in this. Friends, there is another mission that Government of India has launched, that is Jal Jeevan Mission. And under Jal Jeevan Mission, you will be surprised, the Government of India has taken a resolve that by 2024, every rural household in this country will have an individual household tap connection. And today, as of today, only 18% households, villages, have individual household tap connection. So look at the challenge that we have. 3.27 lakhs villages out of total of 17.87 lakhs villages. So this is another area where the Rotary is going to engage in. The third, washing schools. Friends, washing schools is a flagship project of a Rotary. We are already engaged in over 30,000 schools. And I would like to compliment 3240 for engaging washing schools in a big way all across your district. Almost every state under 3240 are currently engaged in washing schools. And the Rotary wanted to build on that success. And there is also a challenge. Although water and sanitation coverage has reached beyond 95%. Over 95% schools have water and sanitation. But when it comes to hand washing with soap, only 55% schools. Out of 15,50,000 schools, only 55% of these schools have hand washing with soap facility. And you can understand the importance of hand washing at critical times. During these difficult times, COVID-19, everybody is focusing and advocating, encouraging that we should be frequently washing our hands with soap. So you can just understand the challenge here. Wash in healthcare, friends. In India, we have 31,000 healthcare facilities across India. And 7% of these facilities don't have water. 45% of these facilities don't have sanitation access. And there has been tremendous challenge because of poor healthcare facilities poor washed in healthcare facilities. Let me share with you, 1 out of 10 patients who go to these healthcare facilities for treatment, and 1 out of 10 comes back with HCAI, healthcare associated infections. And this HCAI is very, very dangerous. It can lead to AMR, because I know some of you are doctors present here, antimicrobial resistance. And that is a major cause of deaths. And it is expected that by 2050, 10 million people will die every year because of AMR. So you can just imagine the challenge which exists in this way. And let me talk about neonatal deaths. Today, 28 babies born out of 1,000 newborn, they die. Maternal deaths, 130 mothers out of 1 lakh newborn baby die in this country. So look at the challenge. These are all associated with poor water sanitation hygiene services and infrastructures in healthcare facilities. So these are the impact. SDC, you may be aware of, Sustainable Development Goals 6, 1 and 2 talks about providing access to water and sanitation. SDG 3, 1 to 8 talks about well-being of human being, talk about healthy lives. And this is where the role of washing healthcare and washing schools and washing community comes into picture. Quickly, let me take you through some of the statistics. Today in India, there are around 4 lakh stunted children, and one of the main reasons is poor wash. Today, 1/4 of our population still defecates in open. The third is 32 lakh children have never been to schools, and that leads to child marriages and leads to neonatal deaths. And in this country, my dear friends, 15,000 children die every day under the age of 5 because of poor wash. So down below, you can see the global footprints, the kind of challenge that we have in this country. And let me, these are some of the components. These are important components of WASH. When we talk about WASH in community, WASH in healthcare, WASH in schools, Jal Jeevan Mission, these are the components. Look at the impact each of these components can have on diarrhea morbidity, because 40% of diarrhea morbidity is only because of poor WASH. Hand washing can reduce diarrhea to the extent of 44%. Hygiene, 42%. Water quality, 39%. Sanitation, 36%. Water source, if it can be improved, can reduce diarrhea to the extent of 23%. So look at the challenge that we have. This is a F diagram. The doctors who are present here today can very well understand the importance of the intervention, how the sanitation plays an important role as a primary barrier in the transmission of diarrhea or the waterborne diseases through fluids, fingers, flies, and fields, and clean water as secondary barrier can play a pivotal role in transmission of, you know, waterborne diseases in food, and hygiene, maintaining personal hygiene can play a pivotal role in preventing the creation of new hosts. So all this things take place when people defecate in open, when they don't maintain good hygiene practices, when our villages, our places don't have, you know, the sanitation access. So friends, this was a brief overview of Water India Sanitation Mission and why RISM. And quickly, I would like to take you through another small presentation which talks about your role and responsibility, so that you know exactly what is expected and what is how you can align with this program. So can you see this presentation, friends? It has come?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the organization structure of RISM. We have got executive committee in place. There is a chair of RISM, there is a RISM office, and RISM office, the chair is going to communicate directly with zonal coordinators. We have got 13 of them, and district governors. This is the organization structure at the beyond district level, and at the district level, district governor leads the team. We have got district sanitation chair, and these are the five subcommittees which will be working under district sanitation committee, and the entire team works under district governor. This is a communication protocol, and of course, executive committee will be interacting or communicating with zonal sanitation coordinators, who will be coordinating with district governors, and then down below, district sanitation chair, and there will be cross communication taking place through RISM office. And this is the communication protocol at the district level. Zonal sanitation coordinator will be communicating with both district governor and district sanitation chair, and who will be communicating with district sanitation subcommittee, and down below is the club president and club sanitation committee. So these are the roles and responsibilities of district governor. I don't want to go into the depth because many of the things have already been taken care of, but Subhashishji, one thing you got to keep in mind, that by September, district sanitation seminar needs to be organized in your district. That is one thing, and you got to publicize, create awareness about RISM through your JML from time to time. Try to cover RISM in your training events, if anything left, and then provide annual report to RISM to be eligible for awards. And there are similar kinds of responsibility. Under DSC, we are going to share this presentation, so there is no need to go into depth. And this is how we are going to do the goal setting. These are five verticals, so you got to set goals under each of these five verticals. And one thing that we have added is number of PR initiatives organized for RISM. Maybe you can combine with other verticals also. Creating public image, creating PR is very, very essential and important. So these are the awards. For every zone, there will be one award for district governor and one award for district sanitation chair. So the annual report becomes very, very vital. And I am sure that your district governor, DSC, would also like to, do their best to ensure that your district gets recognized. So these are the social media presence of RISM. We have got dedicated website that is going to be for all the eight verticals. There is going to be one particular section for RISM. So this is under preparation. As soon as it gets ready and launched, we will come back to you. We have got a dedicated Facebook group, Rotary India Sanitation Mission. We have got over 2,000 the members in this group. So please join this group. We have got a presence on Twitter, and probably you would like to join Twitter, and there is a dedicated handle, Rotary India Wash. And WhatsApp, We have got the WhatsApp group created at the national level, and we strongly encourage that at the district level, there got to be the group comprising of all the sanitation team and the zonal sanitation coordinator. Probably you would like to include your club presidents also in that, so that there is a mutual motivation, encouragement, sharing of new ideas, so on and so forth. So thank you so much. My presentation ends here, and over to Orijit for the further presentation.
Danny, please unmute Arjit da. Yeah, I have unmuted. Arjit da, you are unmuted now.
Yeah. Now my presentation. Friends, Rotary India Sanitary Mission, we have heard from our chairman, it is Ramesh Agarwal, in details. Now, what this Rotary India Sanitary Mission, I am not going in details to it. I have no need of that. But we have come to know that our Rotary leadership in India has decided to launch this mission to achieve certain goals by 2025. And those are under various verticals. Verticals are in front of you in the screen. Friends, these verticals, what I wanted to tell you, we know what are the works under this vertical are, because we in our district, we have thoroughly done washing schools by many of the clubs, that are vertical number 3, and also community and public toilets construction have been done by many clubs. Apart from that, the new subject for us, the vertical one is ODA plus villages. Friends, ODA plus villages is a little bit pertinent to this post-COVID scenario, because it will speak for the mainly sanitation and hygiene for our rural people within our district. And that is why we should do work on this ODA plus villages with little, which will be little challenging, and we'll have to do some work with little bit of devotion. Apart from that, the tap connection to the individual houses, this comes under Jal Jeevan Mission. I know many of the clubs have provided this deep tube well and well for the potable water to the villagers as a part of their club projects. But this will be something little in details in the line of JJM Mission, Jal Jeevan Mission of our Government of India. And then washing healthcare facilities are almost same, similarly to these washing schools. And this is also a new vertical for all of us to work with. And then I would like to go a little bit in details. My presentation will give you a little bit detailed idea. It has got a schematic approach to all the verticals, giving you an idea how we should work with. So the next one, it is already told to you that in 2014, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced that we shall, our this country will go for ODF, and he formally launched the mission on 2nd October 2014. While the ODF was 39% only, and in 2014 it was 39%. And it went up to 99% in June 2019, and on 2nd October 2019, our gram panchayats across India declared themselves ODF. But that was not all sufficient, though it has been done in 10 crores of households with the toilets, and covering 6,03,055 villages in 706 districts and in 36 states and union territories of India. But to sustain the gains made during the mission, and to ensure that the health and hygiene benefits continue to be realized, the Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation, Ministry of Jal Shakti Mission, has launched a new strategy, and that strategy is ODF Plus. So,
Arijit, sorry to interrupt. Your presentation is not coming up, Dada.
It is not coming up?
No, I don't think you have shared the screen.
I have shared the screen, but...
If you want, I can... I have the presentation. If you want, I can present.
But it is showing in my... This thing. Anyway, you share it, then I close.
Sure. You just let me know. Just... Next, and I will keep on sharing.
Do that?
Yeah. Can you see my screen?
Yeah, your screen is visible.
Aapko? Yeah.
Now you go to the screen number 7.
This one?
Yeah, proceed. Go. Go further. Further. Next. Yeah. Now, friends, what are the elements of ODF? Before that. Raja?
Uh-huh.
Earlier one.
Okay.
Earlier one. Much before. Earlier. You have come to this. You go to the ODF.
ODF.
This is one.
Okay.
Element of ODF plus villages. No. Next. No. Forward.
Yeah, forward.
Yes, this one.
Okay.
Next. I have covered this. Next. Yes. Now, friends, the elements of ODF plus villages, the sustained usage of individual household latrines. IHHL stands for individual household latrines. So it needs to be ensured that every household toilet is continuously be used by the household owners. It has been seen that though the toilets are built under ODF, but the villagers, the household owners are not using it regularly. So that is what we need to see in the ODF Plus. Then sanitation coverage of all the household, including the construction of individual household latrines in new households. That you will have to ensure that every household in the village has a functional toilet by building toilets wherever necessary. Wherever toilets are defunct, make them functional with necessary repairs. That will be our job. And retrofittings of existing toilets. Retrofitting existing toilets means with an additional pit, as many of the existing toilets may having just a single pit at the initial stage of construction. So provide something with a component or accessories not provided during the initial construction. So next point is construction of community and public toilets. By that, it means that we will have to construct community sanitary complexes in Gram Panchayat to cover the needs of floating populations such as melas, tourist places, religious places, etc. And we all know what is behavioral change communication. These activities on sustained use of toilets need to be done. Adoption of twin pit technology, good hygiene behaviors, such as hand washing with soap and critical times, and menstrual hygiene management, and promotion of solid and liquid waste management. Raja, next slide. Other element of ODA plus villages. Raja, next slide, please.
Is that
other elements are sanitation coverage of public space, schools, healthcare facilities, etc. We need to ensure that all the public facilities have functional sanitation facility. And the next is solid and liquid waste management. Friends, this is a little bit of critical and essential subject to be dealt with while going for this mission work, in this, particularly in this vertical. And that has been has got two basic principles: segregation of waste at source, that we need to do it, and which will enable safe handling of the waste. And the second one is reduce, reuse, recycle, and recover process, and also the refuse or dispose paradigm for conserving resources. Let us understand what are the components of solid and liquid waste management. These are biodegradable waste management, plastic waste management, gray water management, and fecal sludge management. Raja, next slide, please. What is meant by the biodegradable waste? This, we need to encourage stakeholders to compose the biodegradable waste at the household level through rigorous information, education, and communication campaign. The community level composting of waste generated at public places and waste collected from the households which cannot compost at their premises shall be done by the GP at a selected place by the Gram Panchayat. Now, the second one is the plastic waste management. The key strategy for the plastic waste management are segregation, that you need to be ensured at the sources. And the second one is the collection. The households with support from Gram Panchayat should collect all plastic waste at the village level. The Gram Panchayat should make arrangements for storage and transportation of collected plastic waste to the material recovery facility at the block level. This is very important. And the next one is the disposal and treatment. All plastic waste collected at the block level must be effectively disposed using appropriate methods. That can be decided with the Gram Panchayat. And the next one, the last one, is again information, education, and communication campaigns with behavior change communication activities to be regularly undertaken with the users and villagers, discouraging the use of single-use plastic along with suggested alternatives and method for its safe disposal. Friends, next one is solid and liquid waste management. Rajal, the gray water. Let us understand, the gray water is the wastewater generated from the water used in the kitchen, bathing place, and washing clothes. When not managed properly, gray water stagnates, leading to mosquito breeding and rich water bodies and rivers, causing both microbial and chemical pollution, contaminating the potable waters. And the in community level, so we can go for the soak pits or leach pits where the gray water can be put into safely. And in the large scale, at village level, conveyance through piping and existing open drain, we can take this gray water to a safer place, and we can do the treatment system such as decentralized wastewater treatment system, waste stabilization ponds, or any other appropriate system. And many of us have seen in our cities STP, soil treatment plant, has been put on the at the mouth of the endpoint of the drainage system, soil drainage system, for making the gray water less contaminated, and then it goes to the water bodies, which become less harmful for people to use the water from the water bodies. The next one is the in the solid and liquid waste management is fecal sludge management. It says about the twin pit toilet technology. It needs to be the preferred toilet technology option for one on-site fecal sludge management. So we need to upgrade single pit toilets into the twin pit. Whatever they are in the ODF single pit toilet, we'll have to make twin pit toilet system. Where septic tank are being, and I want to remind you when we'll go for this twin pit toilet system, septic tank system, we'll have to take care that these pits are at least 10 meters away from the potable water of the household. And the last one is where the septic tanks are being used, the provide soak pits invariably or arrange for discharging of the periodic at periodic intervals of 3 to 5 years as may be required. Friends, many of us have seen even in the urban area, we have septic tank, but we don't have soak pit attached to it. So which is necessary to ultimately have a less contaminated discharge from the septic tank wastewater. So next one, I am switching over to the next vertical of our mission, which is Jal Jeevan Mission. This is about providing tap water to the villagers. Har Ghar Nal Se Jal is our Prime Minister has announced it. As per the Drinking Water and Sanitation Department, Government of India, on 31st 3 2019, it has been announced that 3.28 crore. Next slide, Shubhashish. Next slide, please. Yes. See the scenario. Sorry, no. Next to me. Anyway, keep it. Keep it. So this 3.28 crore out of total around 18 crore rural household in the country have tap water connection as of now. Thus, before this 31st 3 2019, thus about 14.6 crore households are without tap water connection, which is a serious condition. And we want that our villagers should also have the dignity of having tap water connection from water sources. So this coverage of HHTP, the Government of India launched this Jal Jeevan Mission on 15th August 2019 to ensure that every rural household in India has a tap connection with service level, which is very important to note, at the rate of 55 liters per capita per day. And that has to be completed within 2024. And now this slide of coverage of HHTP household tap connection. As you see, that status of the household tap connection as on April 19, the states highlighted in orange indicates that household tap connections coverage is only 5 to 10%. Friends, our district is mostly, except the Bengal, it shows that we are in a very, very poor state of affairs, having only 5 to 10%. So this will be a big challenge for us. Of course, Mizoram shows that it is having the green color. So we'll have to work little hard to, fulfill the goal set by Rotary India Sanitation Mission and our district. Next, Shubhashish. Let us understand what are the components of Jal Jeevan Mission. Every household in the rural areas shall have a tap connection by 2024 with a service level of 55 liter per capita per day. So that is the objective of our this verticals work. Then next is development of reliable drinking water sources. In the villages with sufficient groundwater availability, we have seen when the quality is maintained, we can use that water for the potable, as a potable water for the villagers, and the same local water source will be used. But in villages with functional pumps, the depth can be deepened if required and can also be used as a source to meet the service delivery levels. Then making water potable, we need to have suitable treatment technology to be used at water source to make water fit for drinking. Those are the objective of our work with this providing tap water to the villagers and retrofitting of piped water supply schemes. In all existing ongoing water supply schemes, take measures to provide functional house tap connections at service level of 55 liter per capita per day to every rural household by retrofitting, because it has seen that though the provision has been made, but they are not receiving 55 liter per capita per day. So make necessary changes, adding necessary components and making it JJM, Jal Jeevan Mission compliant by 2021. Now, here the grey water management is also there, which is similar to this ODF grey water management, and we will have to take up wherever it is necessary. So I am not going in details the same thing again. I am straightway going to the support activity of this slide. What means support activities? It means the information, education and communication, also HRD, then training development of utilities, water quality laboratories, water quality testing and surveillance, R&D, knowledge center, the capacity knowledge centers. Friends, here before I miss one point, I want to tell you, in our state, many villages are having the problem of arsenic and fluoride from the groundwater. And when we'll be exploring the groundwater for providing tap connection to the household, we must take precaution about this arsenic and fluoride contamination. And we should have necessary arrangement for remedial measures to those two ingredients, which normally contaminate the drinking water and not at all suggestible for to be used as drinking water or potable water. So with this, I am switching over to this capital building of communities. Capital building is a process of developing and strengthening the skills, instincts, abilities, process, and resources that communities need to survive, adapt, and thrive, and achieve sustainable outcomes. So let us see in the next slide what says about the scheme cycle for JJM project. The phase one begins from district water and sanitation mission. You will have to identify your village with the district water sanitation mission for their approval of cost estimation for JJM works. Then phase two is commences from award of work to the commissioning of the scheme, which you will get 6 to 12 months time. And the next one begins once the scheme is commissioned. So we should remember one thing given in the slide: for single village scheme cycle can range between 12 to 18 months from the day of Gau Panchayat resolutions, which has to be taken before inception of the work. So next is the broad outcome of the JJM. This is reduced waterborne diseases and healthy rural communities, reduced dragging of women, reduced dropout of upper primary school girls, increased employment opportunities for the rural youths. And the next, please. Next vertical is the community and public toilet. It is a very common vertical for many of us. We have done so many toilet projects at the community level as well as public level. So next slide will tell you about the public toilets. Next slide, Shubhashish. Next slide, please. Yes. Public toilet facilities are provided for the floating population, general public in public places like markets, bus and train station. No, you go to the public toilet first. Previous one. Previous one, please. Yes. And the tentative cost of these public toilet facilities are shown here as rupees 98,000 per water closet seat and urinal rupees 32,000 per unit as per the Swachh Bharat Mission guideline. Next, community toilets. We know what is community toilets. These facilities is a shared facilities. Those are to be provided for a defined group of residents or community. It is normally located in or near the community area. It has got sanitation like public toilets. Apart from that, it has to have these bathing and clothes washing facilities. The tentative cost is same for the water closet and the urinal, but it will involve little more cost because of the bathing and clothing washing facilities. So next slide. Next slide. Gender sensitive toilet facilities. This is very important. Community and public toilet facilities need to be gender sensitive. So it has to have easily accessible. It has to have basic facilities like water and electricity. It has to be properly maintained. Otherwise, it will become defunct. So the toilet has to ensure privacy, dignity, and safety also for making it friendly for the public use. And the ladies' side should have menstrual hygiene management as well as child care facilities. These are the gender-sensitive toilet facilities need to be there in the public community toilets and public toilets. Next, what stages involve in community toilets and public toilets? First stage, field data and analysis for the inception of the project and need for the project to understand need for the project. And second stage, design and construction, which includes site mapping, design, drawings, and bill of quantities. The third is a cost estimates that has to be done with the land cost, construction cost, and operation and maintenance cost. The fourth one is very important, sources of funding. Financial contribution from various sources, users' charges, cost recovery, cost subsidy. Then the fifth one is the contracting. The roles and responsibility has to be understood by the contractors and the contracting type. Then the final next one is operation and maintenance that involves staff requirements, cleaning schedules, and consumables. The third one is the monitoring, which has to be done regularly by the club along with the stakeholders, and the progress report also need to be sent to the RISM. Next. Now, washing schools, which many all of us knew what it is, but even then, friends, let us brush it once again. Whatever RISM has designed as per its one of its vertical. So the benefits of washing schools. Next slide. Shubhashish, next slide. Washing school refers to water, sanitation, and hygiene infrastructure and services in school. WINS is acronym for washing schools. We all knew. Washing schools is a flagship program of Rotary India. Rotary in India is engaged in over 30,000 schools across India for washing schools benefiting over 6 million children and 5 million families. We should be proud of that. All Rotarians, even our district has done a lot of washing school projects. It is an integral part of the Washington School's target challenge of the Rotary Foundation of 2016, since 2016. So next slide, Shubhashish.
RTN Gautam, G-O-U.
What are the essential, sorry? Any problem?
No, go ahead.
Shubhashish.
Go ahead, brother, go ahead.
No, the essential elements of wins you have missed before this one. Okay, coverage. Coverage of Washington schools. Before that, you have the coverage of Washington schools. It shows that there are 15,50,000. Okay, that I have finished. Okay. The coverage also, once again, you can show the earlier slide. Earlier slide?
Yeah, I'm showing that.
No, earlier one. Previous one. Yes.
Previous one.
The coverage of schools, as you all know that it is 15,50,000 schools in India. Out of these, 70% are government schools. And no earlier one. In that 90, earlier one.
This is the earlier one.
No. Previous one. No.
Then forward.
Next to next. Yeah, forward. You forward it.
This one? Or should I go forward?
No. You should go forward. Don't go backward.
I'm going forward. This is forward slide. Benefits.
What is the next slide? Yeah, this coverage.
Okay.
Right on this. Oh, no. Why it changes, I don't know. Previous one.
Coverage of Washington schools?
Yeah, beyond this. Okay, friends, 95.2% schools have functional separate toilets for girls, and 93.2% of schools have functional separate toilets for boys, 90.7% have functional drinking water facilities. Our challenge comes here, where only 54% schools have hand washing facilities with soap. So these are the information from UDICE and the UNICEF of 2018-19. So we'll have to give thrust on this point of having more hand washing facilities to the schools as a part of our WINS vertical project. Next. Next.
Benefits of?
Yeah. Benefit of washing school, yes, stay on this.
Okay.
As you all know that it helps in washing school promotes gender equity. It increases enrollment in the school. It helps in better education outcomes, and it increases the attendance of the students in the schools. Also helps in generations of children, and children are agent of change. The next is the essential elements of WINS. Next slide, please. Yeah, what are the essential elements? We can make two types of components of these elements. One is hardware component and the other one is software component. What are the hardware components? Those are the construction and repairs of gender segregated toilets, MHM infrastructure, providing hand washing with soap and drinking water facilities. And also MHM provision, menstrual hygiene provision. And the software components are MHM training, operation and maintenance, and BCC, behavior change communication activities, hygiene, education, and building the capacity of the stakeholders. These are the essential, we knew it. We will have to do even with this when we'll go for the work with Rotary India Centre Mission. Next slide. defining success of washing school. Yes. Implement hardware changes that build hardware facilities, toilet, hand washing, MHM infrastructure, drinking water, etc., and provision of related service and manage construction of all these hardwares. Then implement software changes that involves BCC activities, teachers training, formation of ball sensors and their training, activating school management committee. The next one is engage stakeholders. In that, we'll have to engage school management committee. Teachers, no, you go to the earlier or previous one. I did not finish.
Okay.
Teachers, students, parents, decide on their roles and responsibilities, identify funding of operation and maintenance, impart skills and knowledge. Then the monitoring operation. Under that, we will have to see the condition and cleanliness of the components that we'll build with the washing schools facilities and utilization of wash facilities, functionality of the school management committee, ball sensor, etc. Then evaluate and program. Evaluate the program that we will do with the attendance and absentees, water-related illness, community engagement, reduction of open defecation. Those has to be taken into consideration to evaluate the program. And the focus on sustainability, that involves financial, technical, institutional, environmental sustainability. So with this view, WASH as a means to better education, not as an end in itself. So now the next slide will tell us about the alignment with national mission, Swachh Bharat mission. Our washing school perfectly aligns with the Swachh Vidyalaya mission launched by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. And Ministry of Human Resource Development is going to launch Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar 2019-20 soon. And you can have this website from the slide for your further information, anything from the Ministry of Human Resource Development. So friends, next slide will presentation will tell us about the WASH in healthcare facilities, which is I think new to us to take up the work under this vertical. And let us understand next slide. Next, please. Next, what is WASH in healthcare facilities? It refers to the provision of water, sanitation, healthcare waste management, hygiene, environmental cleaning, infrastructure, and service across all parts of the healthcare facilities. Next. Next. Healthcare facilities that provides healthcare, including in the primary healthcare centers and clinics. Secondary and tertiary are the district and national hospitals, and the temporary structures also included in this, and that those are designed for emergency context. So those will be considered as a healthcare facilities, and we need to take up this WASH in healthcare facilities in all those places. They may be public or private. They may be located in urban or rural. Doesn't matter. We will select accordingly, as per given guideline by the RISM. Next. Next, Subhashish.
Yeah, Dada, given.
Next, it takes little time to come.
Oh.
So, Washington healthcare facilities, you know, this India already, our Ramesh ji has told you, the 31,000 healthcare facilities are there. Very challenging situation is this, the 7% of these facilities do not have water and 48% have no sanitation. So we'll have to give thrust on that and work to see that these are achieved. So lack of functional toilets, safe water, no soap at the hand washing stations. And the next one, poor hand hygiene behavior practices by the staff. And about this, Ramesh has also mentioned the mothers die, 130 mothers die for every 1 lakh children born, 28 out of 1,000 newborn do not survive beyond their first month. So next slide will tell us about benefit of wash. Next.
Yeah.
Benefit of washing healthcare facilities. It reduces diarrheal and other healthcare associated infections. And it also improves healthcare facilities and services. That whatever state of affair as it is today, it will improve to a great extent, and that thereby it will reduce the cases of deaths, and also it will shorten the hospital stay and lower out-of-pocket payments. So these are the benefits, and it will also improve hygiene practices at home, because the staff who will have the practice this hygiene at a hospital will go back to home and maintain that. Friends, now this slide will give you the names of the prospective partners. Oh, these are the elements of washing healthcare facilities. One slide I missed it. This will have to work for safe and reliable water supply, safe and accessible toilets for patients and staff of all ages, genders and abilities, because there may be the toilet, but we cannot be in a condition to be used by physically challenged people or the children. So we'll have to see that also. Hand washing stations with running water and soap. We'll have to see that effective cleanings are done regularly, and the safe waste management system is there in place, and operation and maintenance plans are there, and good hand hygiene practices is maintained. So also the last one, we'll have to take care of training of healthcare staff and capacity building. These are the elements of washing healthcare facilities. With this, I think I will like to know prospective partners. They are UNICEF India, World Vision, Sulaw International, Aga Khan Foundation, PhD Chamber of Commerce Industry, Rural Development Foundation, India Sanitation Coalition, Habitat and Humanity, Give India, Tata Trust and Tata Projects. My request to all five co-chairmen of five verticals, please try to find out yourself in coordination with the chairman, who all of them will be working with you for particular verticals, because many of them become partner as a financial partner to the projects. Many of them, they give their expertise of this working to the verticals. So find out, and finally to go for the goals for the district. So next slide will tell you an average costing of the project. The ODA plus villages, as it has been shown by RISM, 25 lakhs, household tap connection per village 10 lakhs, washing school 2.5 lakhs, washing healthcare center facilities 3 lakhs, and community toilets and is 10 lakhs of rupees, and the public toilet costs 8 lakhs of rupees. So with this, friends, the goal, last slide will tell you about the goal set by the RISM. It is in totality for next 5 years, ODA plus 5,000, out of which in 2021, 400 for the districts of the India. So our district will have to look into considering 40 districts in India, 10 plus villages to be taken up as a goal for the 2021. We'll have to set goal like this. Similarly, household tap connection, 40 villages we need to cover. Washing schools, a little more than 300. And I know that this we are not lacking in any way. Perhaps we have done in last few years also around 300 plus washing school project by different club at their own sources or from the global grant or from the district grant. So next washing healthcare and community toilets, public toilets, 50 each by districts of India. So in our district, we will have to plan for at least 1 to 2 numbers each. So these are the goals. We shall have to set the goal accordingly. And please set the goal. It is my honest request to the district governor-elect Subhashish. Let your co-chairs set their goal, what is possible to complete in 2020-21. We cannot allow spillover to the next year, because next year will be more overburdened with the goals, as you see from the chart. So this is one thing is very important for all of us. We should start working. My honest request to the co-chairs of and the chairman of this RISM of my district, please start working. Anytime you feel, you can contact me. I am there to support you, help you in whatever way you want. And the next slide, this is meticulously, very nicely composed by our chairman, PDG Ramesh Agarwala, chairman of RISM. So he thank you all on behalf of this presentation, as well as next slide, Subhashish. Thanks from my side. Thank you very much. Stay safe. Do not forget to contact me in case of your necessity. And good luck to all of you for the year 2021. Over to Subhashish.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, General Coordinator, Past Governor Arijit ji, for your elaborate descriptions or the goals that you have set, and I'm sure the district committee is looking at this figures very minutely, and I'm sure they will come back to you for maybe some questions or some clarifications. And as of today, I am proud to tell you that out of 91, I could see that around 85 club presidents have joined the president elect.
Subhashish, it is a very good number. I could see that 170, 59 and all that. It's a good response from the Rotarians, not only your office bearers for level 2.
Correct. And we have a lot.
Thank you once again for helping me with your this slide presentation.
My pleasure.
Because I am with a very poor infrastructure here in Mohali.
No problem, Dada. It was all my pleasure. And I'm sure Ajitda and Ramesh ji, my team will come back to you, and we would put our best effort in 3240. I know 3240 has a lot of opportunities to work on this field. And as the India map was showing, I could see that for Jal Jeevan, we are, and the majority part of 3240 is below 5%. So definitely,
you have one point I want to mention. You have one past additional chief engineer, former additional chief engineer, public health engineering, who is the co-chairman of this Jal Jeevan Mission.
I know. He is the subject expert.
Yeah.
Gautam Pal from Silchar, RC Silchar. So, friends, thank you very much for your patience hearing to this great leaders of National Committee. I'm sure you have consumed a lot of things, but same time, something may be coming out in your mind. We have a quick question answer session. You can put up your questions to Danny Datta. But before that, I just failed my duty. If I won't present my four committee subcommittee chairs, and I'm sure they are here. Danny, you are ready with four committee chairs?
Yes, yes.
Can you just spotlight Dr. Shamal Roy from RC Guskara? Dr. Shamal Roy would be looking after the healthcare part. He is the co-chair for healthcare. Shamal Roy is a very, very energetic Rotarian, and age cannot.
Shamal Kumar Das, you mean?
Shamal Kumar Das, sorry, my bad.
Yes.
Dr. Shamal Das. Thank you, Dr. Das, and I'm sure we are looking forward to your effort and your service in this committee next year. Thank you. Danny, spotlight.
Yeah. Both
of one. Rotarian Gautam Pal, G-O-U.
Yes, I found him.
Yeah, Gautam Pal from RC Silchar. our Jal Jeevan warrior from 3-4-0. Gotunda, welcome. And I'm sure with your partnering experience and knowledge, 3-4-0 will certainly do something good in Jal Jeevan mission. Thank you so much. Thank you. Danny, can you contact Joyjit Pal from...
Yes, just a minute.
Joyjit Vishas.
Yes. Vishas is the past president, rather a charter president from Greater Silchar. It's a very, very dynamic club. Jaijit has his own experience of constructing a lot of toilet blocks and all that. So that's why we have kept him in such a department, whether he would be a co-chair for public toilet blocks. And we are expecting a fabulous support from Jaijit next year. Jaijit, all the best and
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Danny, we have Chandan Roy.
Let me check. Chandan, no, we don't have Chandan Roy.
Yes. Amar ekta committee modhe rakhche. O er lage introduce korlo on
sob. Joydeep, mute yourself.
Joydeep, mute yourself. We don't have Chandan Roy.
Chandan Roy is not there?
No.
Okay. Okay, we have one more co-chair. He is also a warrior, the veteran Rotarian, not by age, but by experience. Chandan Roy from Bardhaman South, and Chandan would be ODF Plus village. So this is
Chandan Ghosh is there. Chandan Ghosh is there, not Roy.
Can you unmute Chandan Ghosh? But he's Chandan Rai. How come with the Chandan Ghosh? No, Chandan Ghosh is the president for is elect for Guskara.
Okay.
Chandan is the president elect for Guskara. Anyway, we'll get Chandan later on.
He's having a problem with the net.
No, he is there, but we are not able to identify his name because he may be logged in some different name. Friends, if you have any questions, you can come up quickly. We have Ramesh ji and Arijit ji along with us to answer your questions if you have. I have one request came into for a question from incoming Assistant Governor Abhishek Jitani. Abhishek, if you are ready, you can ask your question to Ramesh ji.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Yes.
Yeah. Good evening, Past District Governor Rutain Ramesh Agarwal and Past District Governor Rutain Arijit Andrew. It was really wonderful to go through your presentation. But I have a question when it comes to the goal setting for District 3-4-0. As I went through and calculated the amount of rupees that would be required to complete all the goals that has been set for District 3-4-0 for the year 2021, approximately it comes to about 11 crores to 12 crore rupees that will be required to fulfill all the goals under the sanitation mission which is required. And we having 91 clubs in our district, if every club also, you know, does a project worth rupees 5 lakh, it comes to around 4 crore 50 lakhs. And the global grant history of 3-4-0 for last few years, if you check, we have done approximately projects of total worth rupees about 5 crore rupees yearly. And we have, you know, remaining 7 other verticals. So if we calculate that per vertical target comes to around 10 crore rupees, so we have a total of 80 crore rupees worth project that we need to do. And our global grant history says that we have never crossed 5 crore rupees a year for the global grant project. So what is your plan that how you'd be mitigating this difference among the funds and how we can overcome it?
Okay. Your first question, 11 crores and total for 8 verticals, 80 crores. First, let me clarify. Sanitation happens to be one of the cost intensive vertical out of all the 8. One, CSR will give you money. You don't have to spend money there. So one of the verticals is CSR. The other one is disaster management. Third is health curative and health preventive. They don't require much of funding. You say health preventing is more of creating awareness. So it's a water, sanitation, and literacy. I think these are the three where the costing will be required. That is the first part. The second part is don't bother about the costing. Go ahead and try to develop a project. We are there to help you. We have got implementing partners. We have got CSR support. We have got Government of India supporting these two initiatives, major initiatives. There is a funding of 1.04 lakhs crores available under ODF plus strategy. There is a funding of 3.5 lakh crores available under Jal Jeevan Mission. So money will not be a problem. There is a will, there is a way. So don't bother about that. Your district has done global grants projects worth 5 crore maybe in the last year. Why don't you try for 25 crores this year? And all these 5 projects, let me tell you, they are all eligible under global grants. There are hungry international sponsors. They are hungry to provide support. We people don't reach out, don't develop projects. Please do that and you will not find lacking when it comes to funding. Our partners, some of them, Arju has just shared with some of the details, some of the partners, they are ready to put in 50%. Government of India is ready to put in money. Under Jal Jeevan, hardly there will be a 10%, 15% costing required if you want to do in tandem with government and state government. So there is a funding package in place. If somebody wants to do a project, say in Kalimpong, a small village near Kalimpong, 90% will be the central government funding. It's only 10% state government is going to provide. In plains, if you want to do it, it's a 50-50 model. So there are a lot of options available. So first way forward is to identify a project and move ahead.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rameshji. I'm sure, Abhishek, you have got some insights from Rameshji's explanations regarding your questions. I can see Shivani Tibru, on the district committee co-chair, has raised her hand. But Shivani, do you have any question?
Actually, I think Shivani already got her answer, reply.
Okay.
And the thing is that Rameshji has replied to all the questions already in chat and in question and answer. He has replied to all of them already.
That is
so the should we still ask them?
That is the problem when you sit with an encyclopedia. So you get answers as a whole. Anyway, and Danny, do you have any other questions?
No, I don't have. Yes. All the questions he have already answered.
Okay.
Yeah, I have one question.
Yeah.
Okay, can I put it?
Galaxy A20, is it Anmona Bora?
Could you? Hello.
Danny, who is that?
Geeta Sapkota from Gentok South.
Yes. Yeah. I have one question, sir. I have gone through to all this valuable speech by the honorable Rotarian, but we have to engage technical person because we don't have any idea to construct the thing like toilet. So many things we cannot do the thing by ourselves. We have to engage the technical person. Can it be done, sir? So if it is done, I'll contact you.
Sure. So you are talking about public toilet construction, or what is that you are talking about?
Public toilet construction, Jal Jeevan Yojana, and everything which you have already placed before us. So we have to engage technical person. We cannot do all the things because we are not technical person, no? So can we take engage technical person, sir, for that project?
Rameshji, let me
he's from Gangtok, right?
Rameshji, yes. Let me give a brief introduction. Geeta is the president-elect from Gangtok South. And okay. She's the retired executive officer of Sikkim government.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So do you want me to reply in Nepali or do you want me to reply in English?
Nepali ma bannai.
Oh, great.
But anyways, jokes apart, don't bother about the technical part of it. You just Google, I will just share with you, just Google community and public toilets. So there is a document available. Please download that from the Google. That is one part. Don't bother about technical part. There is hardly any technical things involved. And we are there to help you. Because we are trying to develop from your district team. We have got co-chairs. They will be further trained. From time to time, they will start receiving all the guidelines. So the first thing is, we got to begin somewhere. suppose in Gangtok, if you want to construct a public toilet or maybe a community toilet, there is a scope and there is a need. Maybe in Ranipul you can do that. Maybe in Tadung you can do that. Maybe you can do that in Deorali. So there are a lot of potential. Do that, funding will not be a problem. Technical expertise will not be a problem. And I'm happy to share for Sikkim and other parts of West Bengal. Already there are so many vendors who have approached me. There is one who is a Rotarian in Calcutta. Shailendra Bhomik. There are so many Shailen Bhomik. Many of them are, they've already started approaching. They are already working in, in West Bengal, in Sikkim, Tripura, Nagaland. So that is not going to be a problem. Once we have a project in hand, things will follow.
Can I add to it, Ramesh-ji?
Yeah, please, Orji-ji.
Can I add to it? Well, Rotary and Geeta, first of all, I want to tell you that have faith on the committee, district committee of yours, that will be working hand in hand. Rotarians of the district, you will find many who has got expertise on these works. As very rightly mentioned by Ramesh-ji, these are not very critical technical works. These are normal technical works. We are doing it in our household also at times. So there will be no problem at all. Apart from that, partners are there. Prospective partners are there. From them, expertise and whatever Ramesh-ji mentioned, we can take the expertise from them. So you simply go ahead. No issue. Thank you.
Orijit Da and other committee members from Silchar, they are already engaged in such kind of projects. He's a retired engineer from government of Assam. So you will find so many such people to help you. So don't bother about it.
Thank you, Ramesh-ji. Thank you, Arjit-ji. We have one question from Rotarian Aditya. Aditya, I have unmuted you. You can ask your question.
Yes, how are you, huh?
Yeah, okay. You are audible, Aditya.
Hello, everyone.
Go ahead.
We are building some toilets, private toilets, in my personal capacity. So can we do that in Rotary? Can we add that into Rotary?
Say that again. What do you have?
I'm building around 15 to 18 toilets in a private capacity. So can we add that into Rotary?
I can't hear. The voice is cracking.
Ramesh-ji, what he is saying is that he's already building around 15 to 20 toilets on his private capacity. Privately, he's building it. Where? So he says, can we add it to the Rotary?
No, in household toilets, public toilets, schools.
That has to be as per the guideline of RISM, number one.
Whatever it may be,
if it adheres to the guideline of this RISM, it can be shown as a project of RISM, no issue. But no friends, issue. I want to tell you one important thing that our chairman Ramesh-ji is going to circulate one manual for this RISM, which will be a guiding factor for us to take up the project, and it will be helping very much to all of us in going with our goals and projects. Thank you. A manual is coming out very soon, I believe, Ramesh-ji.
One thing, let me add more here, Aditya. We got to have a holistic approach. One of the problems that we have with Rotary in India, we will just pick up one particular component and try to do that. That is not going to serve the purpose. Just Mr. Orji just shared with you, there are 7 elements of washing schools. So you got to touch each one of these elements. You got to lay equal focus on each and every component. Then only the program will become sustainable. You will be able to achieve success. So the software, hardware, everything needs to be taken care of. And this is what Orji Da is trying to tell you, that the project will adhere to RISM when you take care of all the components.
Thank you. Thank you, Ramesh-ji. Thank you, Aditya. I think you got your answer. Friends, I could see in the chat and the question answer, a lot of questions were asked. But as I said, when you sit in front of an encyclopedia, you have a limited question. So when the question answer session comes, because Ramesh-ji has answered all those questions in the question answer box, I could see. So with these words, I do not have any questions as of now. I would request, but before that, I just convey my thanks to the district secretary incoming for events, Ankit Agarwal, for organizing this webinar meticulously and coordinating with everyone and getting a highest number so far as today, 372. Well done, Ankit. Thank you very much. And Arijita and Ramesh ji, if we do not have, we can proceed with for the formal vote of thanks.
One announcement and information I would like to share, that I am on the board of VASRAC, Water and Sanitation Rotary Action Group, and they have recently launched an initiative whereby they are encouraging Rotary clubs to submit their water, sanitation and hygiene related global grant applications VASRAC for their review. Not only VASRAC is going to review your application, they will also give you $1,000 for that project, and Rotary Foundation is going to provide additional $500. So you will be benefited by $1,500 by going through VASRAC, and your job will become much easier. So I encourage each one of you willing to planning to go for a global grant for these projects, please route your application through VASRAC, and Arijita will provide you the details for that. Also be present. Thank you.
Sure, Ramaji. Thank you so much. Ramaji, before I request the district chair to present the formal vote of thanks, I have one small quick question as my extended team is in this call. You mentioned in your address that by September, we should be finishing our sanitation workshop. That in the district.
Seminar.
But looking at the situation, we are not sure whether in September we would be able to have any gathering of
Rotarians. If not otherwise, it can be virtual seminar, no? Because right. Now, so it will depend upon the circumstances.
Correct.
And
how things are going. Right. So it is based on the
Shubhashish, I want to suggest on this point. Let us go for a seminar in the style that let the Rotarians who are serious about doing this project come up with their questions and clarifications they need to have on sanitation.
Right.
And that we can have in the Zoom meeting also this way.
Sure.
No issue. Sure. Particularly, those who want certain clarification, if they comes, then it will help us in going for the setting up our goal.
Sure, definitely.
Okay.
And Arijita and Ramesh ji, I did my...
Rajat Dalmia wants to ask a question.
So quickly spotlight Rajat. Rajat Dalmia is a past president and a past assistant governor from Rotary Club of Kalimpong, close to...
I know Rajat.
Yeah, you know, that's why he otherwise Rajesh would have gone for a sleep. He's an early to bed man.
Kalimpong, bro.
Yeah. Rajat.
I'm unable to unmute him, that is.
Rajat, I can see Rajat in the attendance list, right?
No, I have promoted him also. Like, let's just check.
No, I can't see Rajat Dalmia. No, I think he's logged out. Can you see?
You have his question with Danny.
No, I don't have his question. He sent a year. Can I put up a question? He had sent it like that.
I can't see Rajat here. I think he has got logged out.
Okay.
Anyway, we will get that question clarified.
Okay. Anyway, he can send this question to me, which I will communicate.
He had sent a message that says Kalimpong needs a lot of ODFs and wash-in healthcare facilities.
That's fine. We'll take a note, and I request District Chair Chandicharan Mandal to take a note on this, so that we can do our review and our basic assessment before we do any projects or something like that. Chandita, please take a note of RC Kalimpong's Rajat's request. So I was saying, Ramesh ji, we did our district training assembly virtually, and I got a feedback from the Rotarians across the district. So for the training program is concerned, they said virtual district training assembly was more useful. So for the training is concerned than the physical. physical assembly.
I fully agree with you, and this is what. And now after port, you know, post COVID, many meetings will happen online. Let me tell you, across the world. So it's a new feature and much more useful than even.
And even in this meeting, I did not expect these 171 people will come.
Right. Anyway, thank you very much, everyone. I would request district incoming district chair for sanitation and hygiene, past president Chandicharan Mandal, to quickly present the formal vote of thanks before we close this wonderful L1 and L2 session. Past president Chandicharan.
Yeah. Yes, good evening.
Good evening.
My dear Honorable District Governor Rotarian Subhasis, all valued invited guests and fellow Rotarians, it's my privilege to have been asked to extend vote of thanks on behalf of RID 3240. First and foremost, I would like to express our thanks to our most valued resource person, PDG Rotarian Ramesh Agarwal ji, our national chairman of RISM, for his valuable contribution and presentation despite of his busy schedule. Just I knew it from Subhasis just before coming to this important meeting. He was in another meeting. Thank you, sir. On behalf of RID 3240, as well as our district committee of district sanitation committee, we are also grateful to you for your valuable answers for the questions coming to you or our committee. Now I would like to add gratefulness and gratitude to our past district governor, Rotarian Origi Dendo, our own governor, but here as a zonal coordinator of District 3240 and 3260, probably I if I commit no mistake. We are also 3260. We are also thankful to our Sunil, to our PDG Sunil Sarab.
Arijitha is coordinator for 3240 and 3262. Two days.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Governor. We are also thankful to our PDG Sunil Sarab, Zonal Coordinator for Rotary India, Water Mission, for highlighting our meeting. We are also thankful to all members of District Sanitation Committee for their participation, attendance, and showing their interest. For your kind information, Rotarian Chandan Rai, a member of District Sanitation Committee, could not able to attend the meeting due to network problem. He was in his native village. I would like to convey thanks to all president-elects and other participants from our Rotary family. And at last, not at least, I want to thank our Honorable District Governor Subhasis for organizing such a meeting on RISM level 1 and level 2. And it would be it would be better to thank Rotarian Ankit Agarwal and Rotarian Danny for coordinating and managing this meeting. I hope all the co-chairs of District Sanitation Committee has able to educate themselves by this important meeting and invaluable presentation of Rotarian Ramesh Agarwal ji and Rotarian Arijit ji. That's all from our end.
Okay.
Thank you all again.
Thank you. Thank you, District Chair Chandi Mandal. Before we add, just I want to add two very important personalities who are making this event success today. My 12 incoming assistant governors, my 12 incoming assistant governors are my district secretary, led by District Secretary General Sunil Agarwal. So they have given their full effort to make this event as successful as anybody else. So I convey my thanks to all incoming assistant governors, district secretariat members, and the very, very important zonal trainer, those who are working behind the screen. Whenever AG has some concerns, AG is reaching out to the zonal trainer. My thanks to all the zonal trainer, 12 zonal trainer who are making this 2021 is a different way and helping us. Thank you so much. Thank you once again, Ramesh ji. Thank you once again, Arijit ji. With this, we'd like to anything to say, Arijit? No. Okay. So with these words, we would express our thanks to both the resource person and Ramesh ji. We wish you all the very best, all success in 2021. I am sure under your guidance, we can see some good lights in this vertical, and 3240 would be able to work hand in hand in a national picture in 2021. With these words, I call off this meeting and good night to everyone. Stay safe, stay healthy, and take care. God bless. Good night.
I'm sure many of them.
Yes, Arijita.
I'm sure many of them. Yes. I'm sure many of them. No.
Arijita, I think your network is
very bad.
Making some issues. Okay.
Rajat is back now. His network was gone. But yeah, Ramesh has already left.
Thank God at least his presentation was okay.
No. Rajat is back now, but he had lost the network. But Ramesh has already left, I think.
Ramesh has gone. Yeah. Ping me and Ramesh, sorry, you woke up late night, but so, because of the network, we could not get you through to ask the question. Anyway,
I know many of your AGM presidents are ready.
Yes, Arijita, come again.
Okay, I can tell you later. No problem. Nothing is there from there.
Arida, you can do one thing. You can off your video and share some information you can share. Yeah.
Okay.
Tell me.
President.
No problem. Okay, Arijita, we will coordinate. Okay. Okay. Thank you, everyone. I am unmuting everyone for a fellowship of 5 minutes. Then Danny.
Rati poru ke takil, ha? Mar given a petition and ganne ka hobo paper script phala re koi.
Great one. Everybody.
What's going on?
We will all dream of nothing but what. Very good punch.
Good night.
Everybody now. Good night.
चलो Yeah, but I'm in a good situation.
More than 26 pages in more.
So Danny, as always, you're excellent.
Thank you, Raj. Thank you so much.
Okay, chalo. Bye.
Okay, bye-bye. Take care.
Sarsitkhani type koi lo, bada mail koi lo.
Hello.
Thank you.
Hello, hello.
Debu, what kotha pati asa bale gol over?
Oh, you phone call se bai do?
Bala zoni. Danny, Danny.
What I want se pat? Oh, don't she say call.
Hello, Jayan Titi bol se.
Rubber, baseball ka phone call se phone uta. Kono voice faces. Bolo, what the hell are you doing?
Ete, boost karak karak faces. Isu
zoni nuara kobo lage bolo. Mur kotha asa na
hoi? Ian, tapos raha hai. Tada bala zoni.
Thank you very much.
Lewis,
me too.
Congratulations. Good one.
Thank you. Yes, Jayanti.
বিটু তুমি কি তো ক্যাপাসিটি দছো
কবিতা 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 মই একো দেখা নাই ডাঙৰ বেহাই ডাঙৰ বেহাই কব ধৰিছে মই একো দেখা
নাই বিটু
গৱৰ্ণৰ গৱৰ্ণৰ
ও গৱৰ্ণৰ
হাবলি গৱৰ্ণৰ ইজ হিয়াৰ
গৱৰ্ণৰ ইজ হিয়াৰ
গৱৰ্ণৰ ইলেক্টেড হিয়াৰ
চন্ডী
হচ্ছে সিএম চিফ মিনিস্টার
আমাকে তো ওই পর্যায়ে চিফ মিনিস্টার রোটারি রোটারি এন হবে হয় যাবে না ট্রু রোটারি এন হয় যাবে না
গোল সেটিং পেজ হ্যান্ডি উইথ ইউ
হ্যাঁ
গোল সেটিং পেজ
চন্ডী এখন
আমার এখন চিন্তা করে গেছে যে কিভাবে গোল সেটিং করব আর কিভাবে ইউটিলাইজ করব আর
আজ থেকেই লেগে যাও
হ্যাঁ লাগতে হবে তবে আমি উই হ্যাভ টু ফুলফিলি রমেশজি বলো হ্যাঁ দেয়ার ইজ উইল দেয়ার ইজ ওয়ে উই শুড ফলো দিস
নিশ্চয়ই
কালকে সকালের ভেতরে রিপোর্ট রেডি করে দে কালকে সকালের ভেতরে রিপোর্ট রেডি করে দে
আজকে সুমিন্দার কোন কোয়ারি ছিল না
কিসের কোয়ারি
আরে তোর তো জলাজন আমি ভাবলাম জলাজন হচ্ছে তো এই কোয়ারি শুড হ্যাভ বিন কাম ফ্রম
আরে আমি তো শুনছিলাম আমি তো সব শুনে শুনে যাচ্ছি
এই তো পাওয়ার শুনে যাচ্ছে মানে
মিটিং
মিটিং কেমন আছো
হ্যাঁ ভালো
ভালো সুমিত ভালো আছো
সুমিত কেমন আছে
সুমিত
অনেকক্ষণ পরে দেখছি তোমাকে হ্যাঁ আমি তো ভালো আছি এতক্ষণ কোথায় ছিলে
এতক্ষণ আমি থাকো আর কোথায়
খুব
ভালো
বলো
আরে আদিত্য ইতনা সিরিয়াস বেঠা হুয়া হ্যায় কুছ বল ভাই
সুন রহা হ্যায় সুন রহা
হ্যায় আদিত্য ইজ দ্য অনলি ম্যান হু কেম ড্রেসড ফর দ্য মিটিং
ইয়া ইয়া ইয়া
এভরি মিটিং
ইজ ফর্মাল
हम लोग देखो मैं
डैनी डैनी डैनी
চন্দন ঘোষ চন্দন ঘোষের ফ্যান আপনার ফ্যান দেখা যাচ্ছে খালি
চন্দন
ঘোষ না থাকলে
আমি ভাবছি ফ্যানটা কার ঘুরছে
ডাক্তার শ্যামল বাবু এসছেন তো ওনার সাথে একটু করতে করতে দুদিক থেকেই হচ্ছিল বলে এই জায়গাটা দাঁড়িয়ে গেছে
আমার একটা সঞ্চিতা ভট্টাচার্য একটা সেপারেট লগিং দেখছি কটা লগিন What happened? Saida Parveen is not video on.
I just promoted everybody who is there in that.
Saida থাকবে না এরকম মিটিং হবে না
আমার কথা শোনা যাচ্ছে ভীষণ ভালো লাগলো আজকে সব শুনে যা সাহস দিলেন তাতে তো সবকিছুই করা যাবে
লেগে পড়ো গোল সেটিং এ লেগে পড়ো
আচ্ছা শুনো টুডে ই ডু নট রিকোয়েস্ট সাইদা টু অন হার ভিডিও কারণ আজকে বর্ধমানে সব বিউটি পার্লার বন্ধ ছিল
আমি ভাবছিলাম বোধ হয়
ও চারটে সেশনে চার রকম ড্রেস করবে আর কি
সবাইকে বেশ ভালো লাগছে
তোমাকে
বলছি
তোমরা তুমি আর সুকুমেন্দ্র তো পাশাপাশি থাকো খবর রাখো না কেমন আছো জিজ্ঞেস করছো
লকডাউন পেরোতে পারছি না দেখা হচ্ছে না
এখন বলছে যে জুমেতেই দেখা করো আর বাইরে বাইরে গিয়ে যাওয়া যাবে না
এটা কতদিন
এটা সুভাষিস যতদিন বলবে এখন তো সুভাষিসের ছত্র ছায়
সুভাষিস যদি একটু মিটিং ডিজিটাল মিটিং ওয়েবিনার মিটিং সব মিটিং হোক ডিজিটাল কোনো প্রবলেম নেই
আরে ওই জন্য তো ওয়াইন শপ গুলো ওপেন করিয়ে দিয়েছে ফেলোশিপ চলে দেবু
ঘুষ করার ক্লাব কেমন চলছে
দু
ঘন্টা লেগে গেল
এই জুম মিটিং করে অন্তত সবার চেহারা গুলো দেখা যাচ্ছে।